You're listening to the CL Podcast, a podcast that highlights the pros and cons of emerging technologies. My name's Ramandeep Saini, and I'm the founder and CEO of Cryptic Languages. I'm sitting down with industry leaders to discuss the implications of the latest technologies on the world around us. Hey everyone, thanks for joining me for the first episode of the CL Podcast. Today joining me is Amandeep Saini, a health science student from McMaster University. She currently works as a research assistant with the Saman Research Group in the Department of Pediatrics at McMaster Children's Hospital. Welcome to the podcast.
Thanks for having me.
Today we'll be discussing the negative effects of technology on health. There is so much misinformation that can be discovered regarding this topic on the internet, So we'll be debunking some of these myths as well. In recent years, it's come to light that technology can affect the way that we sleep. Can you highlight some of the ways that this may happen?
For sure. One of the most common ways that technology can affect your sleep is because of the artificial blue light that's emitted from devices and even some energy-efficient lighting. The reason that this can cause you to stay awake for so many hours is because blue wavelength light actually boosts attention, reaction times, and your mood. It also works to suppress the release of melatonin, which is a hormone that's very critically needed to fall asleep. One of the myths that's associated with this topic is that blue light causes damage to your eyes, particularly the retina, which is a very important structure at the back of your eye that picks up all the light you receive and also sends signals about what you're seeing to the brain. But we don't have conclusive evidence in science to prove that blue light is damaging to the retina or causes conditions such as macular degeneration.
Does this mean that using the night mode feature on devices can help with reducing exposure to blue light? This includes the feature that changes the light from emitting blue light to yellow light, and the feature that changes the text to white and the background to black instead of the other way around like it usually is.
So the first feature of switching from blue light to yellow light may actually be more detrimental than keeping the blue light on, because one of the studies done at the University of Manchester concludes that when using those two lights on mice, the blue light affected the sleep patterns of the mice less than the yellow light did. And this likely happened because blue light is actually closer to the light emitted at twilight, and the yellow light is closer to the type of light emitted during the day. Therefore, it's probably better to just put away your devices 1 to 2 hours before you sleep. As for changing the background from white to black, this is better than having a bright background in the dark as it increases eye strain, but still, I think it's better to just not use devices before going to sleep.
Wow, that was incredibly insightful. Now, going back to the issues with eyesight because of technology, can you highlight some of the ways that technology can negatively impact our eyes?
So using technology has been cited to lead to a number of issues with eyesight, including watery, dry, itchy, burning, sore, or tired eyes, as well as blurred or double vision, and even increased sensitivity to light. And to help with the irritation, people should take a break every 20 minutes and look further off into the distance. And the reason that our eyes get irritated is because when we're looking at a screen, we aren't blinking as often as we should, and taking breaks might help with this.
That's a great tip and very easy to apply to our daily lives. Now, what about Wi-Fi? How does Wi-Fi impact our health?
So Wi-Fi does emit radiation, however, it's a relatively small amount, and since Wi-Fi has not been around very long, we don't really know the long-term effects of constant exposure to it throughout our lives. But for people that are concerned about the potential effects it may have, some of the precautions that can be taken to prevent radiation from leading to some of the other conditions they may be worried about could be to turn off the Wi-Fi router at night, and this will also prevent people from using their devices at night, which may lead to better quality of sleep.
Definitely a great tip. Moving on, is there any way that our posture while using devices impacts our health as well?
Yeah, so this is an aspect of technology that does impact our health as well. Since technology has been integrated into our lives, we spend most of the day sitting, and this can lead to becoming overweight, obese, and potentially lead to other conditions such as diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and colon cancer. And in addition, we usually slump to be closer to the screen, so this can lead to back and neck issues as well.
Wow, it's crazy how just sitting in a certain way can impact us so much, and even sitting in general. Obviously, we have a younger generation that's growing up with technology, and things like social media can negatively impact their mental health. Can you elaborate on this topic?
For sure. Some people go as far as to say that social media could actually be an addiction. I think that it can definitely cause some users to neglect their own personal health because of the long hours they spend on those platforms rather than using that time elsewhere, such as directing it towards physical activity. To add to that, sometimes when people use social media, they talk about feeling sad or jealous, as they only get to look at the way that other people have chosen to portray their lives in a very positive light and only showcasing the best parts of themselves. And not to mention, social media can be a place where cyberbullying can take place, potentially impacting the mental health of younger people. So when using social media, it may be good to keep some of those things in mind and also make sure it doesn't become something that consumes you.
Wow, thank you so much for all of the insight on how technology can negatively impact our health. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks to all of our viewers for tuning in for this episode. And stay tuned for the next episode of the podcast, where Amandeep will be back to tell us all about the positive impacts of technology.